my name is Kerry Kautzer, and welcome to Keep It Simple, my art exhibit here in the University of Wisconsin-Sheboygan Fine Arts Gallery. And this exhibit will be on display here throughout the month of March. To give you some background history on how I became interested in art, I attended Lyman Elementary School here in Sheboygan over 50 years ago. And at the time, my art teacher, his name, Mr. Hansen, would travel throughout the school district and to visit schools and teach art once a week. I enjoyed learning about art at that time and continued throughout my life up to this point. Another experience in art, in 1990, I attended a drawing class here at the University of Sheboygan and enjoyed that also. And I also took a workshop at the John Michael Cole Art Center, landscape watercolor painting, taught by Dr. James Michael, who was my mentor for a number of years. And I learned a lot from him. And right now, why don't we take a short tour of the paintings I have on display and hope you enjoy and learn some ideas about painting. The first 37 of the 40 paintings are all watercolors. The first painting on display, titled Cedarburg Farm, is a painting I did on location during the Cedarburg Plein Air Festival last year. What caught my attention was the farm in this meadow, and it was surrounded by million-dollar mansions. So at one point, this was a real working farm, but due to time and expansion, things have just changed quite a bit over the years. This next painting is titled Ice Age Trail, and it's the headline painting of the exhibit Keep It Simple. I chose it because I thought it really typified what my work is all about, simplistic colors and shapes. I like the way the path leads to the people, and this was painted from a photograph I shot during a hike on the Ice Age Trail itself, and it's been a very enjoyable journey. Now this next painting, titled Sheboygan Harbor, it was done on site with our painting group last summer. I like the simplicity of the painting itself, and notice the sky colors. They flow into the buildings. This particular painting is more on the horizontal, narrow, panoramic view. Now in this next painting, which was done at the Kohler Andre State Park, it is titled Juniper Trail. I like this format because it's narrow, it keeps your view to a certain degree, and it helps eliminate unimportant items from the painting itself. The viewer scans across the bottom right to the point where the trees are and the people that are walking through the tree line. The next painting is titled Lilac Beach. This painting was completed on location at Kohler Andre State Park during the time when lilac fully bloomed in the tree lines above the beach. Kohler Andre is a favorite place to paint, particularly for Jim Michaels. In this painting, I like the colors of the lavender lilacs and the trunks of the tree. The next painting is titled Silent Refuge. It's a scene from Nicolet Bay at Peninsula State Park in Door County. It's a value painting done with only two colors, burnt sienna and cobalt blue. I like the softness of the scene, and I did a number of test paintings before I achieved the effect I wanted. This painting is titled Wandering Rock Island. It's another watercolor painting done on location on the eastern shore of Rock Island State Park. It's just off the tip of the peninsula and 2 miles off of Washington Island. The island has 30 rustic campsites. It's a wonderful place to explore, but be prepared for a lot of walking. No vehicles are allowed or bicycles. This painting is titled Summer Camp. It was painted on location from the boat landing at Elkhart Lake. The scene is the summer camp Broges, which is owned and operated by Indiana University, which provides outdoor adventures for families, students, for over 100 years. While finishing this painting, it began to rain. You can notice the rain dots on the paper. The next painting is titled Out to Pasture. It's from one of my over 1,000 photographs I've shot during trips to Door County. I like the overall painting, the house in shadow, the light on the silo, the grazing cows, the eye moves around the scene. The next painting is titled White Chevy. This painting was from another scene in Door County. The original scene had a truck which was painted green. To enhance my focal point, I decided to paint around the truck and keep the paper white. It appears to have worked. The next painting is titled North Point Storm. It was painted on location on a Saturday morning after a storm was passing over North Point. I was pleased at how I was able to render the storm clouds as they appeared with the hope of clearing skies to come. All right, this next painting is titled Criterium. It's from a photograph I shot during a Heritage Square Criterium bike race a few years ago. And this particular painting was cause for a lot of detail work, something I'm not used to. And whether or not my idea of what I wanted to do and what I accomplished was maybe two different things. But it was a challenge. This next painting is titled Island Truck. It's a painting I did on location at Rock Island State Park. And I enjoyed the scene. Once again, a path moving down the picture, having the viewer look at this path. Also, the truck was off to the one side next to the wood cage. This was an interesting painting with a number of values, from the dark shadows of the trees to the colors of flowers. Very enjoyable to paint on location. This next painting is titled Point Lobos. It's a painting done on location at Point Lobos State Park near Carmel, California. This particular painting is something that I like the style of the clouds and the mist of fog coming in. At this time of day, it was early morning, so it was low tide. There were numbers of different colors and variations from the ground or the beach to the water and the sky. It fell together pretty nicely. This next painting is titled Across the Bay. It was also done on location on a beautiful Saturday morning while camping at Peninsula State Park. The painting itself was done from Weborg Point, looking across the bay to Fish Creek. And in this painting, I like the way the shapes of the buildings are. And you can notice the masts of the sailboats. These were scratched into the paper, a technique that I occasionally use, but not very often. This next painting is titled Sunrise Charter. This is from a photograph I shot during a fishing trip on South Pier. Now, when you go fishing off the pier, you have to get up around 4 a.m. I don't recall if I ever caught any fish that morning, but I believe from the colors in the sunrise sky, I think that day was worth the trip. This next painting is titled Relent. It's a scene of the Pigeon River here in Sheboygan. And with our mild winter we had, there was little snow, but the river was very low. And in this painting, I kept the gray colors that are typical at this time of year, but I really like the way the reflection in the water turned out. My next painting is titled Cityscape. This scene is of Milwaukee's skyline at dusk. I like the rich, deep colors of the buildings and the water. It was a challenge to achieve the effect I wanted. I feel I came close. There are some paintings I attempt several times. This was one such painting. The next painting is titled Port Clyde, which is located on the Atlantic coast of Maine. It was painted from a photo. I like the particular scene because the positioning of the boats during the low tide and the misty effect of the fog that had come in that morning. The next painting is titled Dreamers. It's another example of a monochrome value painting of the same color. The actual scene was a sunrise, but I went a step further with the color Dreamsicle, hence the title, Dreamers. Last fall, my wife and I spent some time traveling in China, and the must-see location in my mind is the Great Wall, which is the title of this painting. It was painted from a sketch I did while on a backpacking trip on the Great Wall. This section is near Jinshanling, 4 hours from Beijing, and is very rugged and difficult at times. The wall stretches 5,500 miles from east to western China. It is a magnificent wonder of man's achievements, especially at the time it was built nearly 2,000 years ago. The next painting is titled Umbrella Bridge. It is from a series of paintings from China. This painting is from a scene in Lijiang. On this day, it was not raining, but the sun was shining. The colors of the umbrellas and the shapes of the building are what drew my attention. Another in the series of China paintings is titled Hillside Lijiang. Lijiang is located north of Burma and Vietnam. It is an area of mainly farmers and valleys and mountainous areas of fog coming down the hillsides. I like the image because the homes appear to be floating in the clouds. The next painting is titled Black Dragon Pool. In this painting, it was done on location near Lijiang. It was an overcast day, and the snow jade mountains were not visible in the background. It is a beautiful scene with a pagoda, white arch bridge, and reflections in the Black Dragon Pool. Shortly after I finished the painting, it began to rain. It rained almost every day while in Lijiang. This last painting from the China series is titled Suzhou Canal, which is about an hour from Shanghai. This particular painting shows old homes along with fishing boats which weave through the city and mainly are for tourists today. This next painting is titled Evergreen. This is a painting done in three to four values of phthalo blue against a viridian yellow sky.
Okay.
The next painting titled Afternoon Hike was developed from several ideas, mainly from what I have seen at the trail around Wood Lake in Kohler. I have begun to include people in more of my paintings. By adding people, it gives scale and life to the scene. Now I have a number of paintings considered to be miniatures, 6x8 or smaller in size. This first painting is titled Esslingen Riverbank. I painted this piece on location along the Sheboygan River during a beautiful fall afternoon. This painting was actually matted down from a larger painting. The next painting is titled Happy Day. It's a scene I created from just an idea of a happy day. where a family is going to the beach. It could be located at Coleraandre or any beach. In the next painting, I chose the title Lasting Impression because it is a scene of my mentor, James Michael. It was the last time I painted with my friend, Jim. The next miniature painting is titled Rounding the Mark. It is a scene of Lightning Class sailboat race. This particular race is the Bratz Regatta. I love to paint scenes of boats, particularly in motion. All right. The last of the miniature paintings is titled Seaside. It was done on location near Carmel, California. One advantage as a watercolor artist has over oil painting, the opportunity to mat out large parts of the painting. This painting is titled Watchdog. This wintry scene is a combination of ideas with a couple and their collie overlooking Lake Michigan. I decided to change the scene to a frozen lake and the viewer's observation of ice fishermen. The next painting is titled A Day in March. It is from a scene at Coleraandre State Park. I like the late afternoon shadows. The next painting is titled Branch River, also painted on location. This one was done in Manitowoc County. I recall it was a late fall afternoon. The temperatures were in the low 30s, just about the limit for watercolor painting, as my fingers began to numb from the low temperatures. This painting is Tough Point. This painting was completed on location in Door County. Tough Point is a nature conservancy area, a wonderful place to visit, hike and explore with very few people. The last three paintings in the exhibit are all done in oil. This particular painting is titled Edge of the Meadow. It was done on location next to our campsite in Door County. For those of you who are not familiar with watercolor paints or oils, there are similarities. Both use a painting surface, either paper, canvas, or a panel board, covered or uncovered, paints, brushes, and that's where the similarities end. Now, as far as the fast drying of watercolors and the slow drying of oil paints, I prefer to use watercolors just for the simple reason they dry quickly. And the cleanup is really amazing how much difference there is compared to each medium. Regarding paint in all the mediums, oil, watercolor, and water-based oil paints, there are different grades, student grade and professional grade. To achieve the highest quality in my painting, I use the top-graded paints just for a simple reason. I want my paintings to last forever, virtually. Besides the paints, the brushes, the material you paint on, there are other things to consider. Matting and framing your work. Now, what's the difference between painting inside or on location? Inside you have your controlled studio. Conditions are your lighting, all your equipment's right there, and everything is laid right in front of you. all your reference material, everything's set. When you stop working on a painting, you come back, everything's all set for you. Now on location, you have to deal with many objects and elements, particularly the weather. Either it's very cold or very hot. The wind has a big effect. Might be a very bug-infested area. You may have many onlookers interested in watching what you're doing. These are some things that you have to deal with painting outside, but I enjoy the on-location painting because of the spontaneity of seeing exactly what you are trying to paint and meeting people. That's all part of it. Now, as far as setting up for an on-location painting, you need several things to carry with you. Your backpack with all your gear, your paints, your brushes, your sketchbook. When I get to a location where I probably have scouted before, I start doing a small thumbnail sketch. And once I have a really nice sketch, maybe you have different angles, it always correlates. When I have a good sketch, the painting is much easier to accomplish what I'm trying to do, and many times it's a really good painting when I have a good sketch. One of the first things I do after sketching, I set up my easel, I lay out my palette, and drop in the watercolor paints, if I'm using watercolors, or oil paints. Both come in tubes that I use. In watercolors, many people will use the hard tablets of paint and then add the water to them and try to mix it up and loosen up the little cake. I prefer to use the tube watercolor paints and just add a little bit of water. And this creates a richer, deeper paint pigment on the paper itself. Other things to consider as far as painting on location, the sun is a major factor. You must protect yourself and your painting surface from the sun. So I use an umbrella occasionally. I wear a hat, and sunscreen is a must. And any kind of protection you need as far as clothing to keep the sun off your skin for protection, it's a good idea. Next painting is titled Wood Lake. It is another oil painting done on location during a summer evening. My attempt is at working with oils painted on boards. I am trying to use the same brush techniques, but the painting procedure is totally opposite. Darks come first, then lights to create the highlights. Whereas in watercolors, the white paper must remain for the highlights. The last painting is titled Labor Day. This is another oil painting of black-eyed Susans in my backyard on Labor Day. I like the diffused lavender background, which helps accent the flowers. I'd like to thank you for taking this tour of my exhibit here at the University of Wisconsin-Sheboygan Fine Arts Gallery. And remember, keep it simple. I'm Kerry Kautzer.